Hello everyone, I'm Khushal. Today I will be discussing some topics of Excel and R along with some detailed examples of how you can tackle those problem statements. We can do a lot of things in R, and these examples that I will be discussing today will help you lay a foundation of a lot of things that you can do in R and Excel. So let's get started.
So this is one sample data that I have for sales month on month, or the daily sales data of a particular shop. The column A actually represents the user ID, and column C denotes the order date, the date on which order was placed or it was sold. Now this data has another part to it, which is the user ID mappings. So these user ID that you are seeing in column A actually matches or maps to the user ID in column A in the second sheet. So in this discussion, I will only mainly be using these three columns. I will just mark them in yellow, and the user from the user ID mapping, I will be using these three columns, just marking them as red. Okay, so once my data is there with me, let's first of all try to see what we can do in Excel with this data. The first thing that comes to my mind is, what is my month on month sales? That is what this shop would like to know. If I just create a pivot table out of it, I might get some idea, but the kind of information that I will get will be very limited. So this is sort of like the count of month on month sales that I am getting. I will just call this as pivot. Let me just add one more parameter here, which is the unit price, or maybe the sales. So what I have now with me is the units that I'm selling every month and the value of those units which I'm selling every month. So this is how the data looks like. Now let's try to do this same thing without a pivot table. So let me just call it without pivot. So months remain as it is. In fact, this data is not month on month, this is actually day wise data. So let me just start with January 2009, and I will take it all the way to October 2017. Now in Excel, what I will do is count of orders, and here is the value of orders. So let's try to construct that same pivot table here again with a month on month trend. So for counting, I will use countifs. The date that I have should be greater than my selected month, and the same date that I have here should be less than the next month. So here we have the count of orders month on month. So this data is can be just discarded because this does not have any data in it. Okay, now to count the value of order, I will use the same formula but with a sumifs. So this formula actually is that sum column F from order sheet, if order C, which is the date column, is greater than Jan 2009 and the same date column is less than Feb 1st 2009. This actually is shows us a trend of how my month on month sales are happening and how my month on month orders are happening. I can actually construct a line chart on this. I can also, what I can do is I can also plot a value chart out of this, which is sales do fluctuate, but it's more or less same. Maybe I have a seasonality, which is like in November my sales goes up and in September my sales is lower. These kind of trend can be easily observed. I do these kind of things. Okay, so the thing that we just did in Excel, we will try to do the same thing into R. So R basically works on the concepts of data frames. So in order to do, for me to do anything on a data, I have to first read that data into a data frame in R. So let's try to read the orders data. So I've created a CSV file first for the same data that I was showing you in Excel. And I am now reading this data into R. This is sales data. This is basically a syntax. So the same data that I showed you in Excel, I have now read it into R. This screen actually tells me which variables I have read. And this is my data, which has roughly 8,399 rows in it, which is same as this. Okay, now let's move on to reading the user's data as well. So these are my users, these are my orders. And user ID is the unique key which actually maps these two data sets. Okay, so let me try to do the same thing which we did in Excel just now. We basically counted how many orders we had month on month, and we also counted how many, what's the value of those orders month on month. Wait, someone is on my door. Okay, let's discontinue. So I've now read my orders and users into a data frame. So now what we did in Excel was we counted the orders and the value of orders by month. So first, in order to do the same thing in R, first I have to create a new variable in orders data frame, which is the month, which actually maps from order date. So if I just use the order date in this month column, I will get the date, but I actually need the month. to be able to aggregate it into month-wise data. So let me just convert this date into month. I can do this by using this formula as dot date paste 0 substring order dollar order date 1,7. So I'm basically taking a substring. I'm basically taking the first 7 character of the date in the data frame. This is first 7 character, and after those 7 character I am appending 01, and then I am converting it into a date and putting it into the data frame. So this is first create a substring, then append 01 into it, and then whatever the text is I convert it into a date. So now if I look at my data frame, in the month column I have the month on which this order happened. Now the only thing left for me to do is to count how many entries are there on every month and count the value of entries which are there every month. So let me just start by counting how many entries are there in this month. I use a library called Plier, and using this library I first of all count orders month on month. So my summary looks like this. So here you can see in January 2009 I had 223 orders. This matches to this. Similarly for all months it will match. I can now also set the column names for my summary data frame, saying that the first column is month and the second is orders, count of orders. So here I have my first summary. Now I need to get the value of these orders. I will again construct summary 2, which is aggregate of my main data frame orders, and I take a sum and in the starting of this function I actually define that I have to sum up I have to sum up sales with month. So I write sales has to be summed up with month. So this is case sensitive, so I have to put S in capitals. So my summary 2 looks like this. So if you just compare it, in 2009 January I had 516,000 as my sales, which matches to the output that I got in Excel also. Okay, now these two are two different data frames. I have to merge these two data frames. So let me just merge it into summary data frame only. So this is sort of a VLOOKUP that we do in Excel. So I do merge summary 2, and these two variables have to be merged by parameter month. Wait, first of all I have to by month, and this is basically a syntax that we follow, that all variables in X have to be kept whereas all variables in Y need not be kept. So just to sum it up, it's just a VLOOKUP that we do in Excel. Yes, so this is small issue. Now, let's see what we have in summary. Okay, now we have orders, sales, month on month. One last thing which is pending is, let me just plot it onto a graph. So for plotting, I use summary dollar x-axis month. So on x-axis I will keep month, and on y-axis, so this actually is like this. And on y-axis I keep my sales type. I basically want a line, so that's why type is O, or maybe I can put type line. X label is month, whereas Y label is sales. Let's see this chart that I got here. It's same as this chart which we got in Excel. So this most likely would be November. This is November, where I have the peaks. September trend is going down. It can be refined further. This is just a basic plot. There are many better plot functions that we can actually use. I can also plot count of orders here. This is, yes. So the same. So now what we have discussed till now is how to get a summary, basically month on month. Which summary need not be sales summary. It might be related to anything, like how many customers are we getting. It might relate into different kind of problems, but all those problems will have one thing in common. You are actually trying to aggregate something onto a based on a particular parameter. Here that parameter was month, and you were trying to get sales and count. Same problems can come up in real life in different ways. So and in this tutorial, what I have discussed till now is how you carry out those kind of, how do you tackle those kind of problems in R and Excel. So in Excel you use SUMIFS, COUNTIFS, and in R you basically read it into a data frame, convert into derive a new parameter or get a new parameter, and do a count and aggregate along with merge. Now once this is done, I can write the output that I got into a CSV file as a final step in R. So once I write this file, I will get it into my working directory. Or if you are unsure about your working directory, you can check your working directory. So this is my working directory, and here I got this new file summary which I just created. I can again do lots of things with this data if required, but this is a summary. Okay. So this concludes the first part that I wanted to discuss, which is understanding how you aggregate different variables in R and Excel. Okay, so moving on, there is one last thing that I would like to discuss in this tutorial, is on categorizing a particular column. So if you look at this profit column, it can be any number, but if you have to analyze a particular column like this, we can actually categorize this column into some categories. So what I will do here is, I will create a new column and will say that if my profit is greater than 1000, or maybe greater than 100, I will say that it's a profit. Otherwise, if my profit column is less than minus 100, I will say that it's a loss. And otherwise, if none of these condition happens, then I will say that it's none. So this is a new column that I created in Excel. We will also do the same thing in R, but let's just look at how you tackle things in such kind of problems in Excel as of now. So now I have these categories, whether a particular order was a loss or a profit or none. Now I may be incurring, one way to look at this data is I may be incurring losses at a particular shipping mode. I want to look at that mode, and that's why I've done this categorization. So one easy way, so let's summarize this data set in Excel itself. I call it as loss analysis, and what I will do is I will just take all the shipping modes and try to see where I am incurring the maximum losses. And this is loss, profit and none. Okay, so this is a 2x2 grid that I want to see where is it that the loss is maximum. So again, recalling the count fs formula, I will just do a count fs if my delivery mode I will freeze this column and say that this should be equal to regular year. So this dollar denotes that cell A should not change, whereas my row number can change. And I will also put a condition that profit should be equal to loss. Again, here I will freeze the row, not the column number. So here I've frozen. If here dollar A indicates A is frozen, here dollar one indicates row one is frozen. So I can, since all dollars are kept properly in the formula, I can copy this formula to all the cells and I will see that how many cases is lying in which bucket. I can also do a percentage of these, saying that this is something like this. So I now have the percentages which I can see. So this clearly shows that delivery truck I am incurring the maximum number of losses, maximum cases of losses occur in delivery truck. That's a very good insight. So the company can actually look to see where the problem actually is in delivery trucks, that 50% of the cases are going into losses. And if you look at profit, seems to be same for regular air and express air. Okay, yeah, just got a call and sorry about that. Let's continue. So now what I was saying is company can actually look that so we have identified that the problem actually lies in delivery truck, and regular air and express air seems to be same in terms of both profit as well as number of cases which have losses. So this is the problem area. So the company can actually look into identifying this problem area and maybe resolving it. So that's how data analytics works, getting insights, such kind of insights. So to get this insight in Excel, I have used countFS and then converted it into a percentage. Now let us do the same thing in R. Also, we also have created a categorization of profit before using the countFS formula. So moving to R, what I have is I have this orders data frame still there with me. I will do orders dollar maybe profit underscore category. By default I will set it to nothing, maybe NA. So if I look at my orders data frame, I will have NA in my profit category as of now. Now I will start categorizing it. It's just not, so in R I cannot do it in a single command, so I am using three different commands to get to the profit category. So orders dollar profit category, so this bracket, in bracket I can put a condition saying that if orders dollar profit is greater than 100, then I will say that it's a profit. Let's see how the data frame looks like. So I have now filled profit. I will do the same command, copy the same command and say that if it is less than minus 100, then it's a loss. So let's look at the data frame now. I've filled up profit, I've filled up losses in the category section. Now this NA remaining, I have to classify as none. So what I will do is I will put it as none, and I will say that if this is NA, then put it as none. So this completes my categorization in R. So now if I look at my data frame, so now if I look at my data frame, what I will see is I have loss, profit and none, all categorized here. And recalling the techniques that I just showed you earlier, which is plier, what I can do is I can do a count, but this count will be a two-dimensional count. Which is to say that I am actually counting wait a second, this is column name is ship.mode. And my second column is profit category. So this is my new summary, ship mode and profit category. The only issue is it's not in a tabular format right now. So to convert it into a tabular format, I have a library which is reshape. So how it works is, I will just say summary2 is equal to cast summary and ship.mode has to be casted against profit category. And I mainly have to do a sum, or yes, so it will automatically pick the last column and will create the grid that we actually want. Now one last thing which is left here is, I will just say summary $2 loss underscore percent is equal to summary $2 loss by summary $2 loss plus summary $2 none plus summary $2 profit, and maybe just for simplicity I will round it off to 2 digits. So let's look at what we have in summary 2. So this is same as this column that we got. Similarly, we can copy the same formula and also construct profit percentage. Which is this. So here we have the profit percentages, loss percentage, number of cases. So this table, again to reiterate, this table actually represents how many cases of losses have we observed in case of delivery truck, express air and regular air. So since in case of delivery truck I have 54% of cases which have losses, this is a area of concern. And to identify such kind of an insight, you need to be familiar with all these techniques, and that's what this tutorial was for. That's it from our side in this tutorial. In our next tutorial we will be covering more examples which will help you better tackle many other real life problems that we keep on incurring every day, and to also help you understand how different problems can be looked at and how analytics can be applied to them using these tools Excel and R. If you have any doubts regarding this tutorial or any doubts on Excel and R, you can mail us at the email which is specified in the description section, or you can also write your doubts in the comment section. Hope you have enjoyed this video and stay tuned for more. We will be back soon.